السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما يا أرحم الراحمين. If someone can tell these kids to be quiet. اللهم بارك لنا في جمعنا هذا واجعله تجمعا مرحوما واجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما. آمين يا رب العالمين. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو، هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر، سبحان الله عما يشركون. So we finished Al-Muhaymin, and then after the Muhaymin today comes Al-Aziz. Al-Aziz is one of the most mentioned names of Allah Azza wa Jalla in the Quran. After Allah, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, maybe Al-Ghafoor, and then comes Al-Aziz. It is mentioned around 92 times. 92 times. And it is combined the most with which other name? Al-Hakim. Aziz al-Hakim. The most combination of Aziz is with Hakim. And also it is combined with Azizu al-Rahim. قوي عزيز. There's one in Surah Al-Buruj, Al-Azizu Al-Hamid. وَمَا نَقَمُوا مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا أَنْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيد. Right? So, this name is a very special name. This name, if we understand it, our whole Muslim identity is based on this name. And when we neglected this name, we have lost our izzah. Al-Aziz, it means few meaning, just like the other names. It means the one who's always victorious, never ever defeated. Al-Aziz, always victorious, never defeated. It also comes as a reinforcement, the reinforcer. As we know in Surah Yasin, about the village whom they had two messengers, فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثِ. Right? فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثِ. What does عَزَّزْنَا here mean? Reinforced. We sent another messenger, a third messenger. So the Aziz also come from the reinforcer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep. يعني يعززك الله حتى تبلغ العزة. This is a beautiful meaning. Allah will keep reinforcing you until you get the عزة. And both are same root. يعزز حتى تبلغ العزة. العزيز is the one who does not accept his slave to be humiliated, the true believer. Now, we all know the story, and I know my young, beautiful brothers, they love stories. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu wa ardah, he was told to come and receive the keys of Jerusalem, right? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all a salat in the Quds, inshallah. Allah, you never know, right? Allah ala kulli shayin qadir. He's the Aziz. So Umar was on his way to take the keys from of the keys of Jerusalem, Bayt al-Maqdis. On his way there, he was pulling his camel, and before he arrived, there was a big pot of mud that he had to step on it. He took his shoes off, put them here, and he walked through the mud. Now Abu Ubaidah saw him coming, and Amir al-Mu'mineen, the leader of the believers, he's coming with patches on his thawb and all mud. So he said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, of course Abu Ubaidah did not mean any insult or anything, ma'adallah, no way. But he does not want any of the non-Muslims to look down on Amir al-Mu'mineen. Is this your Amir? So he came and he said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, you're coming to receive the keys of Bayt al-Maqdis looking like this, with all the mud and everything. Wallahi ya Aba Ubaidah, if someone else said it other than you, I would have made them example to all Muslims. نحن قوم أعزنا الله بالإسلام فمهما ابتغينا العزة بغيره أذلنا الله. Very famous statement of Umar. نحن قوم أعزنا الله بالإسلام فمهما ابتغينا العزة عند غيره أذلنا الله. And this is exactly what's going right now. We are قوم, we are people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dignified us, honored us with something called Islam. Ya akhwan, maybe just quick history. The Arab, before Islam, the worst kind of people on earth. Ignorant, illiterate, unorganized, you name it. And at the same time, when the message was revealed, there was something called Romans, and there was something called Persian empires. Ya Allah, the Romans are there and the Persians are there, and you chose the Arab to put the message in them? There's a hikmah from the Hakim. Subhanallah. So they were very well known to be inconsiderate at all, nothing. So the Islam came and gave them that honor and that izzah. They felt something amazing. So he told them, we are qawm, we were nothing. Allah honored us with Islam. And if we seek honor through other than Islam, listen, my young brothers, my young sisters, if we ever seek honor and dignity through a path other than Islam, Allah will humiliate us. Allah will humiliate us. This is a statement of Umar. Now, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, ya akhwan? Allah said, الَّذِينَ يَتَّخِذُونَ الْكَافِرِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ مِن دُونِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The one who take the non-believers as their awliya instead of the believers. Now, the word awliya, unfortunately, is translated into, in the Quran, in the translation, into what? Huh? Friends. And anytime you go to an interfaith meeting, the non-Muslim bring this ayah and you say, your book say, do not be our friends. But as we all know, if you know simple Arabic, you know that awliya or wali is way much bigger than a friend. Friend is sahib, sadiq, zamil, rafiq. These are all friends. It varies. Khalil, it depends on how strong is your friendship. You can choose one of those five meanings of sahib. But wali is much deeper. Like, for example, Rasulullah SAW, he said, النكاح بلا ولي باطل باطل باطل. Marriage without a wali is void, void, void. Could it possibly mean marriage without my friend is void? Impossible. Really? True? Right? So, wali is much bigger than a friend, an ally, a guardian, someone who's in charge of your main affairs. Allah is saying, الَّذِينَ يَتَّخِذُونَ الْكَافِرِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ مِن دُونِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The one who take the non-believers as their awliya instead of the believers. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? أَيَبْتَغُونَ عِنْدَهُمُ الْعِزَّةِ. Do they seek izza with them? فَإِنَّ الْعِزَّةَ لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا. Allahu Akbar. Are you becoming friends with these people? Are you forming allies with the non-believers against the believers? You think you're going to get honor and dignity from the non-believers? The izzah belongs only to Allah. Only to Allah, only to the Aziz. من كان, another ayah. من كان يريد العزة فلله العزة إيش؟ جميعا. You want izzah, you want honor, you want respect, you want dignity. The only source of that is Allah Azza wa Jalla. If you seek it from any other source, you'll fail. You'll be humiliated, exactly the opposite. You have a goal, you want to do something, you have a goal in front of you, and that goal is izzah. This is the way to it, through Allah Azza wa Jalla. Any other way, not only you don't get it, you will get exactly the opposite. Subhanallah. Not only you will not get it, you will get exactly the opposite. So ya akhwan, for anybody you know or anyone amongst us that is trying to hide his Muslim identity, wallahi, you will only be humiliated sooner or later. You're going to be humiliated sooner or later. Anyone who tried to hide and pretend that he's not a Muslim. I was getting no names phone from a store. Huh? And I went in there and I saw the name of the brother is a Muslim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Alaykum salam, how can I help you? Mashallah, you're from this country? Said, yeah, how can I help you? You speak Arabic? Shway, shway. How can I help you? La ilaha illallah. Yeah, and it's so obvious. Please ignore this. Let's get to business. Ya akhi, what am I going to tell you? Give me a discount. Yani. What I'm saying is, you're my Muslim brother. Talk to me. Tell me what's the best plan. Tell me something. You know? Not even consider. Yani, it was so obvious. Please lower your voice. Don't embarrass me. It was so obvious. Do not embarrass me. Ya Habibi, if you are that worried, your name is very obvious that you're a Muslim. Change it at least. Call yourself Mike, Jimmy, Steve. You know, this name is, I don't want to say it. Huh? Subhanallah. So when we do that, you are looking for, sooner or later, you might get happy for a while. You think that you are honored, huh? Because your friend is so-and-so and your ally is so-and-so. But sooner or later, wallahi, you will be humiliated. Because you are going to get the izzah from the wrong sources. Allah said, أَيَبْتَغُونَ عِنْدَهُمُ الْعِزَّةِ. You want izzah from them? Okay, I'll show you. And we have seen it. I don't want to go into politics, but we have seen it in the Gulf War. When we seek the izzah from somewhere else, what happened? Subhanallah. So, Al-Izz, there is a very honorable scholar, his name is Al-Izz ibn Abd al-Salam. He went to the ruler of Cairo one day and he said, Ittaqillah, fear Allah with your people and rule them with justice. Fear Allah with your people and rule them with justice. So his wife, when he came home, said, how dare you? How dare you speak to the ruler of Egypt like this? Aren't you scared? Because these people, you know, killing and spitting is the same. They don't care. He said, Wallahi, before I go inside, I thought of the izzah of Allah Azza wa Jal. I thought of the izzah of Allah Azza wa Jal. So when I looked at him, he looked like a small kitten in front of me. Like a small mouse. The Aziz is with me. The Aziz is with me. What do I care? Subhanallah. When we reach that level of Iman and understanding of the names of Allah Azza wa Jal, which is the whole goal of this halaqa, Subhanallah, your mentality will completely change. You know, the Aziz is with me. Who are you? He could, the most victorious, the one who will never humiliate me because I'm connected to him. He's with me. Subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a Subhanallah, very the hadith what we all know, and I will finish with this because I promised you 15 minutes. I will read it in Arabic first, and he said, the hadith is famous. Yushik al-umam an tada'a alaykum kama tada'a al-akalatu ila qas'atiha. Faqala qailun, wa min qillatin nahnu yawma idhin. Qala bal antum yawma idhin kathir, walakinnakum ghutha'an ka ghutha'is sayl, wala yanza'anna Allah من صدور عدوكم المهابة منكم ولا يقذفن الله في قلوبكم الوهن قال قائل يا رسول الله وما الوهن قال حب الدنيا وكراهية الموت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said the people will attack you just like someone is invited to eat dinner like you are the dinner and everybody is eating from it there will come a day that all the people will eat from you just like people are gathered around the dinner. Someone said, Ya Rasulullah, because we are few in that day, because just the number is very small. He said, no. You will be numerous, you will be a lot. But you are kawtha as-sayl. You are just like the scum of the sea. No use. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take, listen to this, will take fear out from the sudur of your enemy. Your enemy will have no respect, no honor to you at all. And Allah will put wahan in your hearts. They said, Ya Rasulullah, what is the wahan? He said, حب الدنيا, loving of this dunya and hating death. Loving the dunya, the reason why people will do this to us is because our involvement in dunya and hating death. On the days of the Sahaba, Ya Akhwan, they used to look forward for death. They used to dream. They, يعني, subhanallah, and what an honor if you have a shaheed in the family. You walk with your head up. Subhanallah. That our love of the dunya have made us forget the reason of our existence. So, Ya Akhwan, Al-Aziz is the one who will give us the izzah. And the only way we could come back, وَلَا تَهِنُ وَلَا تَحْزَنُ وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ Don't fear, don't grieve, don't worry. You will be on top. You will be superior if you are true believers. If we are true believers. Now the question is, when we go home today, tonight, are you Abdul Aziz? Not Abdul Aziz, your name. Huh? Ask yourself, Am I the Abd of the Aziz himself? Am I the Abd of the Aziz? Subhanallah. And by the way, when you hear the name Al-Aziz, if you have any new baby coming, a boy, Wallahi, what a beautiful name, Abd Al-Aziz. Huh? Subhanallah. You appreciate the name more when you know what does the Aziz mean. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give izzah. Like we end every day, how can we use this name? In our dua, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا يَا عَزِيزُ يَا عَزِيزُ أَعِزَّ الْإِسْلَامَ وَالْمُسْلِمِينَ Right? يَا عَزِيزُ أَعِزَّ الْإِسْلَامَ وَالْمُسْلِمِينَ وَخْذُ لِلْكُفْرَ وَالْكَافِرِينَ. This is the name. This is the way we could use this name in our يا عزيز ارزقني أو أنعم علي بالعزة. Bless me with عزه in my life. Subhanallah. So such a beautiful name, ya akhwan. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant izzah to this ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people understand and listen and understand and apply, inshaAllah ta'ala. May Allah forgive our sins and unite our hearts. Jazakum Allah khair. Mubarakallah feekum. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. So Thursday will be my last halaqah before I go to Hajj. So make sure you come, inshaAllah ta'ala, so we can give you a special name for Allah Azza wa Jalla.